Hi everyone, I hope you're doing well. So in this video we have to discuss lead code problem of the day, and today's problem is sum of subarrays minimums, and it is a medium layer problem. So the problem says that we have been given an array of integers. We have to find the sum of minimum of p, where b is each of the subarrays in the given array, right? So basically for all the subarrays in the given array we have to find their minimum value and sum all of them. So there will be actually multiple ways of solving this particular problem, and we are going to discuss one of them. So in this particular problem, what we are going to do is, let's say we have this 3, 1, 2 and 4. So 3, 1, 2 and 4. So let's say we store the pairs of this particular node value and its index. So we have 1, 1 and then we have 2, 2 and then we have 3, 0 and 4, 3. Right. So what we have done is we have basically stored these elements and their corresponding indexes and just sorted the whole array. So now the array is in increasing order. First of all, there is 1, 2, 3 and 4. Right. Now what we do, we take this particular whole range. Right. We take this particular whole range and find out the position of the minimum in this particular range. So we know if we take the whole range, the minimum will be at the top of this particular value. Right. So what we can do is, this is the minimum that we know. Now we need to find out into how many subarrays will this minimum contribute. So there is one element to the left, there is two elements to the right. So how many total ways will be there to choose a subarray such that this particular number is included? Right, this is my question. Now those will be 2 into 3. Let me tell you how I came to this particular number. On the left there is only one element, right? So there are two ways to choose elements from the left side, that is I take 0 elements or I take 1 element. Similarly on the right side there are 2 elements, so there will be 3 ways to choose. I can take 0 elements from the right or 1 elements from the right or 2 elements from the right. These are the 3 ways. Now the total number of ways to choose a subarray such that this value 1 is included in that particular subarray will be 2 into 3, that is 2 contributing from the left and 3 contributing from the right. So basically the size of the left side plus 1 and size of the right side plus 1, we have to multiply both of them. So these will be the total number of subarrays, that is 6, in which this particular 1 is present, right? And in each of the subarrays its contribution will be 1 because the value is 1, right? Now let's say we have figured it out for the smallest element in the array. Now what we have to do is, let me just erase all of this. We just have to call the same recursive thing on the left as well as the right arrays, right? This is the left part and this is the right part. We just have to call the same recursive function on the left and the right half as well, and this will now take care of everything. So basically we are dividing our problem into smaller parts, and solving those smaller parts independently, right? So again I am going to call on the left half and the right half. So now in the left half the smallest number will be 3 and in the right half the smallest number will be 2. So what we are going to do is, in the last call we were here at this particular position. When I call the left and the right half respectively, I am going to call my position at this particular position and as at this particular position. Why am I doing like this? Because this number was already taken, right? The top number has now already been taken by this particular position. When I call on the left and the right half, I take my position as this one, right? That is the immediate next position. But as you can clearly see that there is a number 3 here, but when I move to the left half and the right half respectively, they both get passed the position to this particular location, right? So I will also have to make sure that the position that I am getting lies inside my current range, only then I can consider it as the minimum, right? So what I am saying is, when you did the first iteration and you took the top element as the middle element or the element with the minimum value, right? Now when we perform some operations after it, we move on to the left and the right subarrays respectively. In both of the cases, we are passing the location to the second element inside my vector, right? Now if I consider the left subarray, you will realize that this second element does not lie inside this left subarray. So what I need to do is, I need to increment up my pointer until I find suitable position which lies inside my left subarray, right? This is what I am trying to say. So you'll have to make sure that the element that you are currently pointing at lies inside the current subarray, only then you are going to perform the operations. And the operations are nothing, you just have to find the element or the minimum element in that particular subarray. So for example, in the left subarray it will be 3 itself, and in the right subarray it will be 2. Count the number of elements to the left and the right of it. So let's say we got one count left and we got one count right. We know the total contribution will be left plus 1 multiplied by right plus 1. Right. So these will be the total number of subarrays. Now we want to find the summation, like the sum contribution. So we multiply it with the array of position, which was the minimum element. Right. So this is the new value that will get added to my answer. And when we call the same function recursively, it will do everything for us. So let me show you the code, what I've done. Initially, I have created a variable L for the array size and I've created an order vector and I've initialized two values, answer and modulo value. Now for all the values, I'm going to set order of I as a pair of array of I comma I and I'm going to sort this order vector. Now I'm going to call at the end helper of 0, n minus 1 and 0. So what are these three values? This is the low value, that is, that denotes the lower end of the array subarray. This denotes the higher end of the subarray and this denotes the current position in this order vector. Now I am going to set my next p as order of post dot second. So basically this next p will be the position of the next minimum value. Now I also need to make sure that it lies inside my array range, that is low to high. So if next p is less than low or next p is higher than high, greater than high, that means it is outside my range and I need to look at the next element. So what I do is next p is equals to order of plus plus position dot second. So it is going to increment my post and then use the next value. Now once I have found a suitable value, I will count the number of elements to the right, that is next p minus low plus 1, and count the number of elements to the right as well, both left and right, that is right to the right side it is high minus next p plus 1. And I am going to add left into right into array of next p to my answer. So left into right will be the total number of subarrays in which the current element will contribute, and array of next p is the value that it will contribute. Right, and I just take modulo, and then if my next p is greater than low, that means there are still some elements to the left. So I'll call helper of low comma next p minus 1 comma position plus 1, and if next p is less than high, that means there are still some elements to the right. So I'll call helper of next p plus 1 high and position plus 1. So this would be the solution of this particular problem, and let me just quickly submit this and show you that this particular code works and this solution is absolutely correct. So you see, this passes all the test cases and this solution is correct. I hope that you guys were able to understand the solution. If you guys did, consider dropping a like on this video and don't forget to share thoughts in the comments, because your engagement with this particular video really helps the YouTube algorithm to understand that this video is actually helpful for you and it will be able to reach much more people like you who want to keep solving new problems. So that is it for today. Till the next video drops, keep coding, stay safe, bye bye.